When it comes to TV technology, a lot can be confusing. This goes for really any screen technology, actually. LCD, plasma, AMOLED, OLED, they're all designed and tweaked differently in search of the most uncompromising picture. And today, a relatively new technology has made its way to the forefront in LG's NanoCell TV lineup. We've partnered with LG in this video to discuss its technical differences and advantages over traditional LCDs, since people seeing NanoCell for the first time probably won't exactly know what it is or how it works. I don't blame them. So let's start with the basics. NanoCell technology is reliant on LCD technology in which liquid crystals alter incoming light from backlights behind them. Nowadays, most of these backlights are LED-based, though other light sources have been used in the past. You'll typically find RGB color filters on top of them, along with polarizers to filter certain wavelengths as they emit outward from below. Now, at this point, liquid crystals and IPS panels controlled by electrodes essentially expand and contract to varying lengths, allowing certain amounts of red, green, and blue from below to pass through. The result is a specific color and brightness value for a single pixel in a huge array of them, creating the dynamic moving images we see in most displays today. Now, where things really get interesting is in the NanoCell department. See, LG's pretty much pushed LCD technology about as far as it can go in its basic form. You get excellent color reproduction in these panels and incredible viewing angles, but limitations in liquid crystal response and shape prevent it from exhibiting deep blacks and minimal ghosting, things where OLED panels excel. So LG added an extra filter comprised of, you guessed it, NanoCells tasked with filtering out unwanted wavelengths of light. This is, in a way, improving upon the already great colors that you find in panels like these. Now, you might be asking, well, Greg, don't LCDs already kind of sort of filter light? I mean, isn't that what polarizers are for? Well, yeah, I mean, you can think of NanoCells like an additional polarizer to the conventional ones you would find in any LCD. The particles in NanoCell film are roughly 1 nanometer in diameter, hence the name, and as a result are able to absorb specific wavelengths of light that standard polarizers and competitor products cannot. The result is an ultra-rich color gamut, like the one you're seeing here. We'll get more into that in a second. And in combination with LG's Alpha 7 Gen 4 AI processor, which leverages deep learning to better optimize content and filter unwanted noise, you'll find that it's one of the best LCD implementations on the market, hands down. So what you're looking at here is the 75 Nano 90, one of LG's largest 2021 NanoCell models. It's super difficult to convey true color quality, of course, via camera, and I ran into the same issue with our LG OLED video, but what I can mention is the color gamut, which far exceeds 100% of sRGB color space, which, for those who aren't aware, is really good, and it also approaches up to 90% of DCI-P3. You can think of this like an LCD on steroids, something I can't really fully explain with words apart from empirical data. You'll have to see it in person to truly understand. I approach the OLED panel the same way, mind you. Colors are incredibly vibrant here, but I can only do so much on video because chances are you're watching this on a different screen with varying levels of color and contrast, so it's not really going to translate one to one. And that's the perfect segue into an obvious shortcoming of LCD technology. Yes, we're going to talk about pros and cons in this video. That's contrast. It's something NanoCell technology simply cannot remedy in its current form. Thanks to where the light is sourced in relation to the color filters and polarizers, it's nearly impossible to get a contrast ratio approaching anywhere near that of OLED. But that's okay. I mean, you're paying for that quality, for that feature in an OLED TV. So it comes down to managed expectations here. Instead, NanoCells do a great job making up for IPS shortcomings where possible in the color department. The true limitation here is the pixel technology itself, and the price you'll pay reflects this. But where I really wanted to see this thing in action was in gaming. The 75 Nano 90 isn't marketed as a gaming TV per se, at least to the same extent that many of its OLED counterparts are. However, some NanoCell TVs out there still boast many alluring gaming features, including VRR for variable refresh rate stability, ALLM for reduced latency, and FreeSync, of all things, right, for consistent frame rates, all of which can be controlled in the game optimizer menu. And as you might expect, the experience is quite good. Plenty for battle arenas and artsy titles alike. Heck, even racing games fare well with this panel thanks to the inclusion of True Motion, which interpolates motion by inserting fake frames throughout a fast-paced scene. And even so, if that wasn't good enough for you, the native 100 120 hertz refresh rate in this thing, and minimal ghosting as seen in this UFO test are a testament to this panel's gaming capabilities. So the baked-in NanoCell technology doesn't hinder the speed of this panel. In fact, it aims to make it more immersive with its precise color reproduction. And on that note, LG does market Nano IPS gaming monitors, which also boast high refresh rates and still great color reproduction thanks to the inclusion of their NanoCell film. So here's a brief synopsis of what NanoCell does and doesn't do. It does improve color reproduction. It also does improve upon IPS technology's already excellent viewing angles. It doesn't solve response time limitations associated with IPS technology, because it doesn't necessarily change the pixel technology itself, as we discussed. Same goes for contrast. And it doesn't improve refresh rates, since that's not for what NanoCell was designed. I suppose it also doesn't break the bank, relatively speaking, and that's why I think it's a feature worth pursuing, at least, in your next TV. Unless you're willing to shell out a few $1,000s for an OLED model like the C1 we featured a few weeks ago, NanoCell is about as good as it gets, and I think you'll be happy with the purchase. Consider checking out LG's latest NanoCell TV models via the link below. I'll also link our C1 OLED video for those who are interested in something a bit more, bit more flashy. That's all for this one. Leave a like, consider subscribing, and I'll catch you in the next one. My name is Greg. Thanks for learning with me.